Hattadiddle felt a large cat armature, and at the same time take some ideas from proper artists about how to improve our craft. Hey, I'm Pam Duthie, and I'm here to help you craft your career with creative marketing and artistic inspiration. And every Thursday we do a needle felting tutorial, so if this is something you're interested in, don't forget, check back every Thursday. Now, if you've ever been in an art class or you've followed any artist, you'll know preparatory sketches and getting to know the anatomy of the animal is so, so important. And I thought we'd have a bit of fun with that with a cat armature today. So as always, I've started off by finding armature reference photographs on Google to have an idea about what the anatomy of the animal we're going to create is like. Remember, these are generally just artist representations. They're not necessarily always exactly how the animal will be, but it gives you an idea and some scale and proportions. This one, a beautiful cat with a skeleton included, but missing out the front of the shoulder assembly. But we can fake it. And then I wanted to take this a step further and work on different poses for the cat, as someone does with preparatory sketches. So again, I found another artist, I'll link to both of the artists below, but who's just got poses, reference poses for cats. And I thought we could see if our armature will make these awesome poses for the cats. So let's get started, and I'm just using the gardening wire that I reviewed in the supermarket wire review video a few weeks ago. So to start with, we're going to need, as always, two strips of wire, one for the head and front legs and the other for the back legs, and always make it slightly bigger than you think you're going to need. As you can always trim bits, it's not so easy to add them. And I'm twisting a section for the head and the neck, just holding the two wires between my thumb. Well, I found the center folded in half, twisting down a length I want, so the skull will be to around here, bending down the neck, and yep, we're going to have the shoulders about there, so one more turn for luck. And second wire for the back and legs of the cat. So again, finding the center point of the wire, having the head facing forwards, taking this loop over the wire, and we're going to hold one side between my thumb and finger of my non-dominant hand, my left hand in this case, and the other side I'm just going to take these and twist one full rotation. This is for the shoulders. Can do, in fact, for this cat we'll do two, because it's a larger armature. So two full rotations, and then the exact same on the other side. Hold the shoulder you've just made and two full rotations. So the legs are pointing down. Try and make it as even as you can. As you can see, I'm fairly rubbish at this. So front legs are pointing down, and we now have the back of the cat. And we're just going to take him and loosely pinch the wires together further along his back a little bit. We're still trying to match everything up here so the sides are about even length. It's not going to be perfect. And give a few loose twists down here. This is going to be his spine. Now, as you can see, if you have too much wire, it kind of gets in the way, but you want to make sure you've got enough wire. Just following this along the back of the cat. And they always tend to seem much smaller than you think you're going to need, which is why I like to have a reference picture of the spine. And that's down to his hips. I'm just going to bend this for his hip shape. We're just going to bring it open slightly. Now I'm just going to give them a little extra just for the width of the hips, so almost moving that up slightly. And here's his pelvis. Now cats, although I mentioned in the small cat armature to kind of drop the knee a little bit, what really is actually happening in the anatomy of the cat, as you can see the picture here, is the top thigh is quite a bit longer and higher up in the body than a dog's. This gives them the power for bouncing. Okay, so top thigh to around here. Bend again for bottom thigh. And pull here. And same with the front leg. Now, as we said, this wee guy doesn't have the front shoulder, but we're guessing it. And often the angles of the top thigh and the top of the shoulder sort of match up. So we're just roughly gonna guess on that. Bending these back. Again, bending for the legs. And figuring out what the paw about here. And so now we've got them, that's the hip bone, that's the pelvis width a little bit there as well. Okay, now if you need to, this wire is quite soft, but you can use needle nose pliers to do the bends, get them nice and crisp, and also to create the paws. But obviously I don't need to on this wee guy because the wire is so soft. Just gonna give him a paw by rolling around a loop and snipping off the excess. Just trying to close that up so we don't have jabby point sticking out where possible. I tend to wrap the paws to wind the shape of the paw in different direction for the left and the right paw. There's no real reason to it, I just feel happier to do that. Don't know where that went. You've got a payoff when you're making wire, when you're using wire for armatures, and it's being soft enough that it's okay to work with while being firm enough that it actually holds its shape. So I would say this garden wire is probably just on the limits of what's going to be reasonable for a sculpture of this size. Now, obviously for our little cat, we're going to need a tail as well. I'm going to go with doubling this over just simply because of the lightness of the wire. I just want something a little bit firmer, so take something about double the length I'm going to need for his tail. And it goes pinging away. And find the midpoint as usual. Going to slide it over either side of his pelvis here. And try and get the wrapping as tight as I can so his base of his tail isn't too fat, and just wrap all the way down the length that I want the tail to be. And you can, even if it's not quite anchored, which it probably won't be, just take this tail and wrap it once round between the legs, through the gap and out the end, and this will just secure it a little bit more. And cats have fairly long tails, but I think that will do. And now I'm just going to wrap him. Now we're just going to wrap him with a bit of fleece. So, strips of fleece. Now I'm not going to put too much fleece on here because this is more like a sketch, a preparatory drawing, than an actual armature of him. So we're making everything nice and thin and just adding points, just like in the sketch. And then adding extra windings in the areas we want a little thicker, like his shoulders and his thighs. So it's thicker at the top, tapering off to the bottom. Give him a bit more cat body. And I'm just going to felt this smooth and then I'll be back. So after about an hour and a half of smoothing out, this is where we've got to. Now with the cat, the way their bodies move, like their flesh moves over their actual joints, means I prefer to felt a cat in the final position you want it to be in. So this means you don't add all the thickness until it's in the position, because certain bends, like if it bends the leg right up, it's almost like the joints sink into the flesh and you've got this big puddle of flesh. That's just how cats are. So we make it to this stage, but there's obviously lots of extra needs to be done to fill in the joints and everything. So for a bit of fun, I want to try some of the poses from this sheet that I found. And if you guys let me know, if you vote on them and let me know what your favourite pose is, and then we'll work on felting the cat solidly in that position. Pose number one, a leaping cat. Pose two, sitting cat. A walking cat. Not entirely sure what pose four is, so we'll leave that one out. A startled cat. Reclining. More reclining. About to pounce down onto something. Having a wee ear scratch. Or having a stretch. So let me know in the comments below how you would like me to complete this armature of the cat. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, remember, click on my wee face to subscribe. Check out the video of the other cat armature, the small cat armature, in the cards up above, and come back every Thursday. Thank you so much.